My dear students, in this video now we are going to study about the Riemann-Tiemann reaction, its mechanism and some examples. Formulation of a phenol with chloroform in the presence of base is defined as the Riemann-Tiemann reaction. So we have to know what is formulation. Formulation means addition or substitution of the formyl group. So we have to know what is formyl group. Formyl group is nothing but HCO group. HCO group is known as the formyl group. We can observe this formyl group in the formaldehyde. Formaldehyde formula is HCOH. And we can observe this formyl group in the formic acid, that is HCOOH. So here HCO group is called as the formyl group, and addition or substitution of this formyl group is known as the formylation. Here the general equation for the Riemann-Tiemann reaction can be written like this. Here in this equation we can observe the phenol reacting with chloroform in the presence of base. Here KOH is written, but instead of the KOH we can use the sodium hydroxide also. But compared to the sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide is a strong base. Potassium hydroxide is a strong base compared to the NaOH. Potassium hydroxide is a strong base compared to the sodium hydroxide. Okay. And here here aldehyde group is substituted at the ortho position to the hydroxy group of the phenol, and the name of this compound is salicylaldehyde. So substitution of the formyl group or aldehyde group is known as the Riemann-Tiemann reaction, and this is carried out with chloroform. Such reactions are known as the Riemann-Tiemann reactions. And substitution of formylation can be achieved with the other reactants like the NN-dimethylformamide also, but that reaction is known as the Wilsmeyer reaction. So we have to keep this point in the mind. And now we go for the mechanism. We can divide the Riemann-Tiemann reaction into two steps for the easy understanding. In the step one, we get a for electrophile. So here in this step what happens means the hydroxyl group from the base takes the H plus ion from the chloroform. Chloroform can be, we can call chloroform as the trichloromethane. In the trichloromethane or in the chloroform, three chlorine atoms are present. These chlorine atoms act as the minus IE group, minus IE group. As a result, they drag the electron pairs from the CCl bonds. As a result, electron density on the carbon decreases. As a result, this carbon drags the electron pair from the CH bond towards it. As a result, it easily loses the H plus ion. So that's why chloroform acts as a acid. Due to that, it reacts with the OH minus ions and forms water, and it forms the CCl3 minus ion. We can call this CCl3 minus ion as the trichloromethanide ion. We can call it as the trichloromethanide ion. Methanide ion. From methane formula is CH4, and from methane we get the methanide ion, CH3 minus ion. We know very well that chlorine forms the chloride ion. In the similar way, methane forms the methanide ion. Otherwise, we can call it as the carbon ion, methyl carbon ion. So if we call CH3 minus as the methyl carbon ion, we can call CCl3 minus as the trichloro मीथेन कार्बोनियम आयन, ट्राइक्लोरो मीथेन कार्बोनियम आयन, लाइक सॉरी कार्बन आयन, सो लाइक दैट आल्सो वी कैन कॉल, बट हियर वी सिंपली वी कैन कॉल इट एज द ट्राइक्लोरो मिथनाइड आयन, ट्राइक्लोरो मिथनाइड आयन. ओके, सो हियर फ्रॉम द ट्राइक्लोरो मिथनाइड आयन क्लोरीन लीव्स बाय टेकिंग द हियर दिस क्लोरीन ड्रैग्स द इलेक्ट्रॉन pair from the CCl bond and goes outside in the form of the chloride ion. As a result, here we get the electron deficient neutral species is formed. This electron deficient neutral species here is called as the dichlorocarbene, and here it act as a neutral electrophile. That point we have to remember. Neutral electrophile. It acts as electrophile because in its outer shell only 6 electrons are there. Okay, so that's why it acts as the electrophile and it has no charge. So that's why it acts as a neutral electrophile. So in the Reimer-Tiemann reaction, in the first step we get a neutral electrophile which is known as the dichlorocarbene. In the second step, this dichlorocarbene attacks on the phenoxide ion. Can be also called as the phenolate ion, either way we can call it. So as a result, this dichlorocarbene is substituted on the ortho position like this. Then after this, we can call this as the intermediate one. This intermediate one undergoes hydrolysis and forms the intermediate two. This intermediate two undergoes tautomerism and forms compound three. Each intermediate has its own name, but due to the complexity of in the names, I am not going to mention the names of the 1 and 2. Tautomerism means shifting of the small groups or atoms like hydrogen is known as the tautomerism. Okay. So here the name of the intermediate 3 is very simple. So that's why we can call it as the ortho dichloromethyl. CHCl2 group can be called as the dichloromethyl. So we can name it as the as it is present in the ortho position, we can call it as the ortho dichloromethyl phenol. Okay, so this ortho dichloromethyl phenol in the presence of the base forms the phenolate ion like this. So we can call this as the ortho formyl benzolate or phenolate. Then after this intermediate 4, we can call it as the intermediate 4. This intermediate 4 takes the H plus ion from the solvent and forms the final product, that is the salicylaldehyde. So here the final product is called as the salicylaldehyde, and the common name is salicylaldehyde, and the IUPAC name can be written as the 2-hydroxybenzaldehyde. IUPAC name for this one is the 2-hydroxybenzaldehyde, whereas the common name is salicylaldehyde. So Reimer-Tiemann reaction can be simply remembered like this. Look here, once again I am going back. Look here in the Reimer-Tiemann reaction, starting substance is phenol, that is P, and we are get, and the end product is salicylaldehyde. Yes, okay now. And Reimer-Tiemann we can write as RT. So But in the English alphabets, we know that P, Q, R, S, T come in the order, no? So it is very much similar to that, but here order is missed. Okay, na? P, Q, R, S, T. But here we have P, R, P, R, T, S. Okay, na, my dears? And here we are not having Q. So that is the difference. So if you remember this order P, Q, R, S, T, we can easily remember what is Reimer Tiemann reaction. In the Reimer Tiemann reaction, starting substance is phenol and end substance is salicylaldehyde. Okay, and that's why its reaction is known as the Reimer Tiemann reaction. Okay, so that's why we can easily remember. And now we go for the some examples to the Reimer Tiemann reaction. So this is example, other example one here. Guaiacol, and the end product is vanillin. Vanillin is used in the cold creams. Okay, and here some heterocyclic compounds like ferrol, thiophene also undergo Reimer Tiemann reaction. Here ferrol forms the pyrrole to aldehyde, otherwise we can call it as the pyrrole to carboaldehyde. Here thiophene also undergoes Reimer Tiemann reaction and forms the thiophene to carboaldehyde or simply aldehyde. Now indole also undergoes Reimer Tiemann reaction and forms beta indole aldehyde. This is a alpha position and this is a beta position, so that's why we call it as the beta indole aldehyde. Okay, and naphthol, this is 2-naphthol. 2-naphthol also undergoes and forms 2-hydroxy, 1-naphthaldehyde. Okay. And catechol also undergoes the Reimer Tiemann reaction and forms the aldehyde. Okay. Thank you for watching.